Does the, you know, the gentle flap of a butterfly's wings create a storm in Texas? You know, a lot of people think that the butterfly effect is a metaphor for chaos. It's not a metaphor, it is real.
In the simulations that meteorologists use to predict the weather, they will run multiple weather simulations with slightly different initial conditions, and the results are then combined to show the likelihood of particular weather outcomes, correct?
Yeah, and then they watch what happens, what takes off in the atmosphere, and pretty much all weather now. I mean, that's how predictions are made, and it's to tame chaos. So chaos is a property of, you know, any system that is evolving over time. I mean, chaos looms so large in our atmosphere. One reason why is it's called the uncertainty principle. And if you go down to the tiniest elements around us, you can't ever know the exact velocity and location of an atom. And of course, you're never gonna know what's just all the little things that are happening in every little millimeter of the atmosphere. Even the tiniest little unknown, eventually it destroys the prediction. That is the essence of chaos, dude. When you talk about chaos theory, a name that's almost always gonna come up is Edward Lorenz, and he was a meteorologist for the US Army in World War II. He was kind of responsible for, you know, creating the idea of the butterfly effect. The idea being little whirls in the atmosphere the size of your thumbnail can cascade up and amplify in such a way that the weather will be impossible to predict in 2 to 3 weeks' time. But that's how potent chaos is in the atmosphere. I think that generalizes to our lives too. There are limits on predictability. When you wake up in the morning, how much of your life is predetermined? If you take two factors, the idea that A, on the, you know, the smallest levels in our reality, we can't know exactly where or how fast, you know, an atom is moving, combined with the fact that chaos exists in systems that evolve over time, unknowns and uncertainties can have such dramatic impacts upon the future, rendering predictability impossible. So Edward Lorenz, he wrote, you know, that we must believe in free will. We must. And if we do, we made the correct choice. But if we didn't, we didn't make the incorrect choice, because if there is no free will, you can't make any choices. The choices apparently have been made for you already. You can start a day, and by the end of the day, you would have never imagined those events transpiring as they did. And that might literally be because of an event like the weather. The day begins anew, but all you can do is tame chaos, man.